Hi, dudes. Hi, host Silver here. Time for some milk and a little talk about different textures that you can get with silver. I'll be sharing two bars at the end of this video, things that I made and have been working on. Cheap, dudes. Today only. Otherwise, I'll probably remelt them. There's a purchase link in the description if you want either of those. But this is kind of an intro to the next few Bunker Bullion series videos where I'll talk about different textures and line techniques and torch techniques, etc. These couple of bars you're looking at here are from phase four and the experimental stuff. I'm just a dude in a bunker, man, but I had a little bit of silver shot and started melting it and kind of fell in love. One of the things I like about it is all the different textures. Check that out. That's from casting with certain temperatures and cooling speeds. I even have my one-eyed Willy skull mold. For whatever reason, that eyeball comes out like that about one out of every three times. But lately, I've been fascinated with this, what I have heard called striation, or sunburst or starburst, etc. A lot of things have to kind of go your way to get this kind of texture, but I love it, and I've taken advantage of it when I get it. I poured some of these for Coin Keeper about maybe a year ago. Anyway, those are among my favorite ever, and part of that is just because of this texture. So I've been melting and remelting. It takes a really pure pour, which is tricky, but I've had some good luck with some rounds that I purchased a while back, and have made some of these sunshine, or a sunburst, I keep calling them sunshine though. Sunburst rounds, super cool textures, and we'll talk more about how that happens, at least my theories on it. I like to just experiment and mess around. These are super cool. Some of them would be in the Connoisseur series, but a couple of them I'll let go here and there. But until I can make some more, I'm gonna kind of scrounge these for myself a little bit. Anyway, I was messing around with trying to get a nice flat mirror finish on the bottom and some hourglass pour lines on the top. So I've got two bars. They're kind of prototypes. These will end up being my 10-ounce bars. Super cool, nice big flat bar. Got really fine lines in an hourglass shape in this one. And then I love that in the center. That's it's like an islands kind of in the midst of a sea there with all those waves. Super cool. I like it when there's lots of different interest to look at. So the more things I can combine into one piece, the better sometimes. Anyway, I've been working on getting that super just clean flat pour on the bottom. And if you pour, you know that's tricky to do. And I've been working on different temperatures and different techniques for heating the mold and how hot the silver needs to be and how quick to pour it, etc. Anyway, here's the other prototype that I've got available. This one and the one I showed you a second ago, I've got listed super cheap and just for today only. Otherwise, I might need to melt those down if I end up pouring some tomorrow. This one's got a similar texture to the other one, but I did double cooling pools. This is actually what I was going for on both of them, where you got the two pools and they kind of almost meet in the middle. And again, trying to get that super flat look. Love it. Well, I hope you enjoyed looking at this stuff. We'll talk more about different textures and techniques in the next five or six Bunker Bullion series videos. So keep an eye out for those. And if you want either of these two nice flat bars, dudes, take a look. There's a link in the description. See you again.